Goedenavond en welkom. Baie baie dank dat jy nou ingeskakel het weer eens hier by Klipkop. Ek sien my kat ook om inloer. Sorry ouwens, ek was een tykie was ek een bykie af gewees. Moet trek het gauw vir en ek myself so half in die oog kyk. Ja, dat is nou al 3 maanden gewees. Ek was jammer, ek moes so bykie van die breek gevat het. Maar ek is nou weer terug vir tenminste 1 episode. Hopelik vir meer. In die vorige episode, dit is nou natuurlijk 3 maanden terug plus een episode, het ons gekyk na, waar is my notas? Ek is alweer uitstekend voorberei. Dit is deel van hoekom ek hier so aan mekaar gestream het. Genade, ek gaan op my boek moet kyk. Ja, die vorige episode, ons oorlog met die kooi, en Doman is geskiet, en as al mense dood aan ons kant, as mense dood aan hulle kant, en dit lyk half asof die kooi, die groepies tussen hulle is, half kop en een mis, eerst was het die ene is ten die ene, en die ene is ten die ene, en die hulle span nou saam met Jan van Riebeek, en dit lyk nou een klomp BS. Die vee doen verskrikkelijk sleg, ons gaan vanavond baie meer daarvan lees, en dan natuurlijk hierdie groot heining, beskutting wat hulle wil bou, om te keer dat die kooi nie hulle beeste wegjaag he. Dis die groot goed, voordat ek in die boek inspring, wil ek eerst een lousie vir die mense in die kleedskoel om. Ek sê goeienaand aan, Brendan Campbell, wat jyl eerste was in die kleedskoel om, goeienaand Brendan Campbell. As ook Mike Simpson, ek neem aan Finney Simpson, is ook daar in die achtergrond, goeienaand Mike en Finney Simpson. Dan het ons ook vir RJJ, en dis al mense wat hier is. Dan wil julle, ek moet meer livestream. Magties, wrachties, daar is Finney Simpson dan nou juis. Moet ek wat gewoon spink van my koffie, die arme kat. Sy bestaan ook hoekom ek hier nou vir haar aandag gee nie. Ek moet nog my side camera opstel. Want ek kyk nou vir julle in my leeskamera. Kom, ek sit om. Gaan ek om daar op die desktop sit? Nee, wacht. Kom, ek sit om daar. Het is toch sy plek. O, jal, hierdie draad was so langlaas verwyder gewees. Gaan hy nog haal. Ek denk ons gaan het maak. Ja. Wacht eens. Leg ons die beentjes op. Oef. Oef, die kat is moeilik. Kom jou toch net gauw hier so, asseblief mense, ek is jammer. Die arme oukiet, wil kiet vir ons die muis vang? Vang vir ons die muis. Ga soek die muis, waar is die muis? Waar is hy binnen? Hy is binnen, jy moet gehoor. Gevang. Dit haar, hou haar gewoonlik bezig so vir wel 2 minuten op die langste. Sy verstaan ook hoekom ek die nou vir haar aandag gee nie. O genade aarde. Desktop full. Waar wil ek hem gehad het? Is moest die rechte plek hierdie. Die focus hier lekker nie. Kom ons stel vir die camera. Properties, configure video. Camera control focus. Set die manual focus aan. Ek denk by 35 is omtrent. Die lekker omtrent, ja. Ek gaan as 40 doen. Nou begin hy lekker weer slechter. Die lekker vir my mooi. Ek sien, oké, Finney Simpson het ook al lauw gesê, Anti-Marxist ZA het ook ingeskakel, goeie naand, Anti-Marxist ZA, en RJJ, klaar vir RJJ gegroet, hier saam 6 mense, kom ons begin, episode 46, die ookie ook so, die slawe en die hottentot, die sê, ek moet alles lees, dit, hulle gee aanleiding hier so, dat hulle so half, beginne saamstaan. die twee groepe, maar ek het dan nog nie meer gesien. Want in die verlede het ons gelees dat wat hulle nie baie van mekaar hou nie. Dis nou op die 18de Augustus 1659. Quite fine, clear, sunny weather in the morning. Not only have the Guinea slaves been stubborn and recalcitrant, but now it appears that they had intended and resolved to escape as a group and join the Hottentots, so all the male slaves have promptly been clamped into chains once more. This has been done so as to prevent such a loss to the company, for should these sturdy and audacious people link up with our enemies, they would be able to cause more mischief and damage than 100 times as many Hottentots. Moreover, they would give the Hottentots too much instruction in warfare, since some of them were in Guinea at the time of the European war there. Nou, ek het actually 'n skakel gaan soek, maar die skakel wat ek gesê het, praat nie eers daarvan. Ek kon nêrens spesifiek, daar was baie oorloë en goed hierso. Gedurende daardie tyd, maar ek kon nie hierdie spesifieke een waarna van die week verwys opspoor nie. En nou, dis eintlik maar so half 'n klein subnotaakie hierdie stuk. Die soldate is weer barstig. Kom ek lees net so begin van die stukkie. In addition, some soldiers who had been sent out this morning showed themselves unwilling to drag from the wood the stakes cut and prepared by the foresters last week for the projected fence which is to prevent the cattle from being driven off. Nou, die vorige episode was baie gelees van hierdie fence. The fiscal was therefore sent out to them, but they were no more willing to obey his orders than the corporals. Okay, so hierdie manne is moeilik, ons gaan nou 'n bietjie meer van hulle lees. En die ouens se lys verwerk, hulle bekke is dik. Ek wonder, kan ek nie hierdie besigheid beter verlig nie. Kom ons doen dit so. Ek kan almal dalk beter sien. Is daai nie beter nie? Ek dink so. Kom, ek maak dit nog beter. Kan sien hoe lank laas ek die besigheid gedoen het. Gehaal, dit val ek vir julle ook. Haai! Ok, ek dink nou gaan alles mooi balanseer. My kamera nou uit Disney's geklap. Is nog by die regte plek. Ja, die soldate is weer barstig. En daar is eindig hy stukkie. Nou, Robben Eiland, 35 skape, bokke, varke. Hierdie is, gaan my eindelijk net oor Robben Eiland. Ek gaan nou nie te veel lees nie. Hulle sit so 'n paar bokke daar so, daar is net 35 skaap op die oomblik daar so. Ons onthou in, wat sê ou se naam, Jan Woutersen. Toe was daar, jy weet, amper 1000 skaap gewees, nou ewe skielik is daar net 35, maar vir een of ander rede het hulle gesê, hy kon nie na die skaape kyk nie. Kyk nou hierdie ryk overraag en hoe gaan dit onder sy toesig. Nou hulle gaan nou 'n klomp, hulle praat van hierdie, een of ander cabbage wat hulle daar gaan plant, curly cabbage of so iets, om 2000 varke daar aan te hou. Among other things, they brought me back a snake, and when it was cut open, I found in it one of the rabbits which I recently brought across with me. I should be glad if your honor would send me two other slaves, because those who are here would rather be at the Cape, and I can get no work out of them, even if I knock them senseless. Nou, maar ek is so half gevoel, ek moet gaan opslaan, naslaan. Jesus, was my Afrikaans swak dees daar. Ek moet gaan naslaan oor wat precies gesê was daar in die Hollandse weergawe. Nou kom ons kyk gauw, sê goed die desktop in. Hier so sê, as hy. Nou net nou daar van die European War in Guinea. Dis nou hier waar ek geloop, kyk het. Blackpass.org. Ek meen, as daar 'n plek sal wees wat dit het, sal dit hierdie plek wees. Nou, ek het nou tussen deur hierdie goed gaan kyk rondom van Rebek se tyd en daar is niks nie, maar as julle daar wil op kyk, ek moet nog die skakels in die description sit. Al sla ek die dood. Dit is wat hy eindelijk hier so. Knock them senseless. Nou kom ons kyk gou na die oorspronklike, die stukkie wat ek wil opsoek het. Die stukkie wat ek wil opsoek het is I can get no work out of them even if I knock them senseless. Nou as ons nou na die desktop loop kyk en ek daar geen werk van krygen kan, al sla ek se dood. So, dit is nie heeltemal, dit is nie knock them senseless as jy direct vertaal nie, maar, duidelik het hierdie ou ook nie letterlik bedoel, hy het hom doodgeslaan, en anders sal hy ons ou begrawe het, jy weet. Hy wil hom eerder maar terugstuur, omdat die ou, die ou smaak my, hy wil eerder graag, weet, aan die, op die hoofland wees. So hy stuur die ou terug, weet, hy is nou nie ernstig gewees oor hom doodslaan, maar hy het hom seker rondgetik. So ek dink, omdat hy hom vertaal het in knock them senseless, is meer akkuraat, al is dit nie, weet, woord vir woord afgebreek nie. Dit is net my opinie. Julle kan een ander opinie hê, as julle wil. Oké. Okay. So ons het nou nie letterlik die slawe doodgeslaan, he. Spreek woordelik. Spreek ook nie, ons wil nie werk, he. Nou, hier is nog van die soldate wat weer barstig is. Ek gaan net so die onderstrepings lees. Yesterday some men showed themselves unwilling to drag from the forest prepared timber intended to serve as protection and bulwark against our present enemies. So hierso verklaar hulle nou 'n wet wat dit nou duidelik maak dat enige iemand wat nou weer barstig is. Hulle gaan ek dink ek het die fines geonderstreep. Hierso is met die fines. For such people the punishment is expulsion from the army. And for the instigators, it is corporal or capital punishment according to the exigencies of the case. Geonderteken naas al die diknekke van Riebeek, de man, Gabema. The fiscal returned home towards evening and reported that the work on the protecting fence was proceeding well under the supervision of the sergeant. Dis maak my, hulle gee net so verklaring hierso, so hoorie, dit is nou wet, en daar is allemaal nou ewe skielik, is hulle nou weer happy. Nou, onze ou Jan gaan doen inspeksie. Hulle sê hierso, he found that the pega-pega intended as a protective barrier. Nou maar, hierdie protective barrier is ons natuurlijk nou die defense, wat hulle nou bou, en hulle sê hieronder, In the journal 5 March 1663, we find an entry to the effect that the fence under the Borsjewel, consisting of dry almond branches, bestaande in dorre amandelbomen, had caught fire. This was probably the pega-pega of Van Riebeek. Nou, maar toe is droe bome en takke, soos hulle nog heel tyd gebeskryf het. Maar in elk geval, hulle praat van hierdie klomp droe takke en goed, as pega-pega. Dit klink vir my amper asof hierdie woord ook uit die ooste uitkom. Oei, al het ek nou hier een stuk misgelees. Ek blaai net gauw terug. Ok, hier sê hulle, Starting from Leendert's forest had already advanced 600 roods. Nou kom ons dit gauw weer hier my desktop aan. Ek het mos die kaartjie hierso, nou maar die plan is mos nou so half van Lenders Forest leemtrend hierso, so dat lyk vir my hulle, ek weet nie of hulle hom hierso uitbou en dan so nie, of hierso in hierdie lijn af nie, in elk geval Lenders Forest is omtrend hier rond. En dan wil hom nou hier sê se kant toe uitbou om hierdie stukkie af te kordon. Ek moet die regte goed voor my hê. Okay, kom ons probeer weer. Vir jou daar, vir jou hierso. Ek is uit oefening uit. Hier is 'n pimperslaaf. Check die. Today two Guinea slaves belonging to Herman Remayen were recaptured at the lower end of the Bos River, which flows out of the company's forest. This spot has been their rendezvous, and there they had erected a convenient shelter and had already prepared for the rest of the companies and all the Freeburger slaves to follow them. But praise be to God, this was prevented in time last Monday, and all the slaves were again cast into chains, with the exception of one, who had brought back his companion. He was therefore allowed to remain free and placed in charge of his countrymen, the company's guinea slaves, of whom he is one. So, as jy jou vriende pimp, raak jy sommer 'n baas. Kan jy nou meer? Ek sien Bebop Williams as ook Christo D. is in die kleedskolom. Goeienaand, Bebop Williams en Christo D. Nou, ons gaan nog baie hiervan ook vanaand lees. Ek weet nie of het 'n uitkyktoring of 'n wagtoring of wat, maar in elk geval, daar word torings gebou rondom hierdie fence om die vyand te kokonots. Dis nou natuurlik op die 25ste Augustus 1659. The framework of one of the watchhouses was taken to its site on four wagons belonging to the Freeburgers early this morning. After the commander had marked out the site, the carpenters began to erect it there and then hurriedly to build it up with boards. It is 12 feet square, 8 feet high, and has in addition a protruding breastwork of 3 feet. It has been named Uitkyk, since it is being placed on a high dune near the seashore to close the passageway between the Salt River and the beach and to prevent our cattle from being driven away by the marauding Hottentots. Maar hulle sê net hier onder daar uitkyk beteken lookout, maar ek is amper seker julle het dit ook geweet. Op die 27ste, hier praat hulle van die tweede wagtoring en hulle gaan dit Keert de Koe noem. Kom ek lees er maar deur. Nearly all the required stone has already been brought there and the timber for the roof and beams is almost completed. The watch house of which the foundations have been laid and which is called Keert de Koe. Natuurlijk keer die koei, stop die koei. Juist, hy is daar so dat die koei nie die koei kan wegdrijven nie. Is situated between the Salt River and the Liesbeek River on a high and overgrown dune-like hill, right in the middle of the route of the ford which the Hottentots take. It lies a good 340 roods from the watchhouse Kyk Uit, and the Salt River flows between the two. Amato, daar is nog al twee torens wat hulle begin. Hier praat hulle ook van Mosterdse Meel. Nou hulle het op 'n tyd terug het hulle gepraat van die meele wat hulle gebou het, wat deur osse en perde en goed moes gebewerk geword het, maar 'n smaak en dit het nou nie so lekker gewerk nie. Nou Casper Mostert was nog die heeltyd so half in charge gewees van hierdie meel story, maar dit smaak met die ou gaan nou vir ons een bou wat met water werk, want die osse besigheid het tot nou nie nog lekker gewerk nie. The Free Miller Wouter Cornelissen Mostert of Utrecht. Kom daar gesê Casper Mostert, Wouter Cornelissen Mostert. Ek dink ek kan my titel ook verander. Has begun to build a new watermill as the horse mill brought from the fatherland and long ago set up together with its accessories in a suitable building cannot be used because the company and most of the Freeburgers have had their draft oxen stolen. As the said free miller cannot make much progress with this work which he has undertaken, and as the supply of ships biscuit last obtained from the ships Ek lees nou baie die mekaar. Kom en probeer nou weer mooi stadig. As the said Free Miller cannot make much progress with this work which he has undertaken, and as the supply of ship's biscuit last obtained from the ships, as well as the rice and groats, has almost run out, it is essential that the mill be brought into commission, so that bread may be baked from flour ground from the wheat of the Cape harvest. So ons het nog nie brood gebak van ons eie graan nie. Om vat geweer so vinnig geswing. Weet julle wat? Dis al 22 oor. Dis hoekom ek so hakkel. Nou moet ek gou. Waar is die kamera nou weer? Hi. Kom ek laat gou engine gesels ek met my mense. Is dit nou hel. Die ding wil nou nie fokus nie. Hallo. Is hy nou beter? Tyd vir 'n smoke break, ja. Finie sê sy is te blind om saam te lees. Die lettertjies is te klein vir haar. Ai, so, jammer Finie. Awe, Christo D. Klippie was op 'n sabbatical. Ek wens ek was. Nee, ek was kaars in die huis uit gewees. Goeienaand, Johan van Bulken. Goedenavond. Stuitsvraad, ek het dit te lanklaas gedoen, ja. Ja, ek het... Ek sien die corona besigheid gaan nog aan. Ek wil nie eers daar oor praat, he. Daar is niks wat ek vir julle kan sê wat julle nie klaar weet, he. As julle wil nou, he, ek moet julle sê, ek stem saam met julle. Oké, fijn, ek stem saam met julle. My lyf is ook moeilik met my vanaand. Ek het actually maar vanavond besluit om weer te stream. Daar iemand anders ter is besig om my episodes weer van nommer 1 af deur te kyk. Dis hoe elke 4de, 5de episode, jy weet, elke 2de week. Al los die ouwe comment, jy weet. En dis nou nie die eerste persoon wat dit doen nie. Toe dink ek op myself, shame, as ook in ander mense wat nou regtig waar tyd sit en, jy weet, hulle belê hulle tyd in hierdie videoreeks nou. As ek nou nie hierdie boek klaar maak, jy, dan gaan... Ek gaan hulle nou teleurgesteld wees. As hulle by die laaste episode kom en hulle sien, ja, maar daar is nog... So, is actually, dis nog 1/3 van die hele boek oor, maar dat is net 'n jaar en 'n half van die verhaal oor. So, hier gaan nog baie, baie, baie goed gebeur. Ons trek nou by episode 47, ons gaan ten minste by 60. Heel waarskynlik hier by 70. Gaan ons loop eindig. Hang af hoeveel hoofdstukke ek op aan doen. Ek moet seker maar in minder detail vanaand gelees. Net gesê het, ja, maar die heining gaan aan. Ons kiep nou oor, want hier kom kooi stories en so aan. Hulle kom maak, wel probeer, wel, van hulle sê, daar moet vrede gemaakt word. Julle moet het maar interpreteer as wat julle wil. Maar in elk geval, daar kom nog diplomatie. Is nog op pad. Alright, hy is halfpad. Ek gaan hom nip. Ek gaan my koffie klaar swing. Dat hy. Ok, nou moet ek die kameraatjies weer recht kry. Waar was ons? Ons het nog laatst by die graan gewees. Wouter Cornelis en Mos, nie Kasper Mostert. Ek dink ek het Kasper Mostert gesê in die beskrywing. Ek gaan dit moet loop verander. Hierso is nou kosverdeling. Het lyk my hulle wil hê die mense moet eerder. Ek het die stuk gaan deurlees. Nie heeltemal sin gemaak van alles nie, maar het lyk vir my asof die mense het heeltyd kos gekry. Met van die maatskappy af. Almal. En dat hulle van die kos gaan nou uitgebetaal word in geld. Dan gaan hulle nou die kosse verkoop. So hulle gaan nou 'n stipend of 'n ding kry. Ek weet nie wat sy regte woord daarvoor is. En dan gaan hulle nou hierdie kosse, kom ons lees gou daar waar geonderstreep het. At the same time, the custom shall be resumed of giving each man half a mutchkin of brandy in the morning, except those who are exempt from guard duty, because the nights here are cold, and the men may thus be less inclined to waste their ration money in the taverns. Ja, mense, ons het nog nie eens 'n brood gebak aan die Kaap nie, maar hier is al kroe. Hier is al kroe. Kan julle dit nou oorvertel? Actually, ja, ek kan glo dis waar. In 'n geval, hier is nou die goed wat hulle verkoop. Fish with entrails and all. 1 brass penny. Vir 3 pond. Daar is nou al die pryse word gefix. Gedroogde vis, gesoute vis. Ek kan skaap koop. Weet, hier is hoenderse goed, ek gaan nou vir julle wys. Nie net hoenderse goed nie. Kaapse botter. Hier so is melk. Hier is eend en gaans en pikkewyne en see. Jy kan vir jou seevoels ook loop koop om te eet. Ek weet daarmee. In elk geval, daar is al die pryse. Jy kan loop naslaan daar, hoeveel is die goed werd. Ek weet, ek sien net nergens, wat kost een pakkie eendjies in die Kaap? Pakkie stuiwissend. Is die tobacco nie hier so nie? Wacht, dit moet hier so wees. Ek maak grapjes hier so. Ok, wacht, dit val seker nie onder kos nie. Maar ek glo nou, hulle sal seker tabak ook verkoop. Daar vir die mense wat nog wil loop saamlees, ek het nou maar net so opgesit dat almal daar kan sien. The object is to ensure that the people can subsist on their food or ration money, so hulle gee nou vir die mense geld in plaas van actually kos. Burgers, varke, die burgers mag nou varke aanhou. In order that pigs may be reared in greater numbers, it has been decided that every burgher living close to the fort shall, for the time being, keep at least 7 pigs. Hulle word gesê, julle moet die goed aanhou. Dis nie van julle kan as julle wil nie, julle moet. Dis waar die verskil kom. Namely, 6 sows and 1 boar. So daar is een mannetjie wat 6 wyfies moet dek ook, so hulle wil die goed moet aanteel. And that any in excess of this number may be sold to whomsoever he pleases at the price mentioned above, but only after each town burgher had been provided with the prescribed number of pigs. So dit lyk my, hulle gaan nou varke begin teel en die mense wat nog nie varke het, hulle kry eerste daardie kleintjies. En sodra almal 7 varke het, dan kan hulle nou onder mekaar begin handel. With this end in view, each shall be granted as much freehold land as he considers necessary for carrots and other garden produce. This shall not apply to those who have their own land in the country, so as not to divert the farmers from growing grain, as we consider the most important thing to be that there should be no lack of wheat and other grain. Okay, dis nou nie vir die boere nie, dis actually vir die gewone burgers. Vir die staatsjapies. En natuurlijk, hulle praat nie van die burgers kan skape ook aanhou. For pressing reasons, it has also been decided that the town burgers in the vicinity of the fort shall, in addition to these pigs, to be allowed to keep Dutch sheep, but shall not slaughter any of them or sell any to people on the farms until they have accumulated a flock of more than 50 head, including 2 rams for breeding. Even then they shall slaughter nothing except rams and wethers. Ewes may be sold by one town burgher to another at a reasonable price, so that each may build up his flock beyond the above mentioned minimum, in order that the crews of the company's ships which put in here may obtain better provisions. The country's burghers too shall be permitted to sell their Dutch or their Cape sheep. Likewise, everyone is allowed to sell any goods obtainable from the company's store, except for the farmers, tavern keepers and tapsters, who are excluded because of their heavy requirements, and in order that the tradesmen may be able to make a better living and draw their small profits. So hulle probeer nou duidelik om 'n hulle wil nou graag 'n ekonomie hierso stimuleer. Hulle wil nou 'n ekonomie stimuleer hier aan die Kaap. Daar kan julle nog so 'n bietjie lees en daar het al die groot manne het geteken daar. Okay, hierdie stukkie het ek gesê rob vleis en bedagsame hottentot. Now, the Skapenjacht, the company's deck boat, who arrived with a cargo of seal meat, it consisted of 9 casks, which she had taken on board from the said Saldanha traders. While our men were there, and the surveyor Pieter Potter was engaged in surveying the bay, taking soundings and recordings, the results so that they may be properly marked on a chart. All this he has completed in accordance with in the instructions given to him on the 29th of July. Okay, ons het daaroor gelees. Hulle moet 'n kaart gaan teken, gaan meet hoe diep is dit oral sodat die skepe nou mooi kan, jy weet. Ons is Hollanders, ons teken kaarte. Europeërs eerder. Nou hier kom die belangrike stuk. Twice our men had seen Hottentots there, 7 on one occasion and 19 on another. The Hottentots had been to the Skapen Island on the Freeman's vessels. They had always treated one another politely, but our men had been unable to obtain in any cattle, as they were beach rangers who subsist on fish. They were well known to our party, and they claimed that though they had heard of the robberies committed by the Karpmans, they had never taken any part. They said that the Karpmans were at present living between Saldanha Bay and the Cape. Natuurlijk, 'n baie groot stuk is. And he's also a fisherman wat afgesterf het. Since last Sunday, a soldier named Louis Labbé has been missing. Early on the morning of the day he had left with the sergeant's permission to catch some rockfish along the shore below the dunes at the foot of the Lion Mountain. This is a common practice. He was seen there by the free miller Wouter Cornelissen Mostert, and for the free tailor Albert Dirkse. But since then no one has caught sight of him, although until today a thorough search for him has been maintained. It is now presumed that he slipped from the rocks and lost his life, or that he has been killed by some wild animals, since no Hottentots are seen in that neighborhood. Nou maar dalk het die ou weggehardloop. Klink julle nie dis 'n moontlikheid nie? Die ouens hardloop weg so ek nou en dan. Dink 'n bietjie aan Jan Blanks en sy manne. Vergadering en dan die torings vorder. Ag, hulle sê net hierso van hoe great gaan dit met die torings. Daar kan julle keer die koei. Hulle moet die koei keer. Nou maar die keer die koe is die toring wat van klip gebou is, en uitkyktoring is die een wat van hout gebou is. Hier praat hulle weer van die pega. Likewise, it seems that not much can go wrong with the construction of the pega as a protective fence under the supervision of the sergeant. Okay, so al die goedjies gaan mooi aan. Hier gaan sommer amper 'n hele week verby. A third, fourth, fifth and mostly unsettled, so was 'n bietjie swak weer gewees en daar is amper niks om te rapporteer nie. Hier word ons nou van die vermiste soldaat. Today the clothing, skull and various bones of the soldier given up for lost on the 30th of last month were found at the extremity of the Lion Mountain, about 30 roods from the beach. The cranium was half bitten off, so it is presumed that he was devoured by a lion, possibly the one from those raids our people occasionally suffer. Nou maar toe, daar het julle dit. Smaak my die leeuw het sy skedel oopgebreek. Robben Eiland, daar was 'n sein gemaakt, die ryk overhaging het 'n sein gemaakt. Nou allemaal was redelijk paniek bevangen, wat betekent die sein, wat betekent die sein? Hulle praat van hierdie vuur wat gemaakt is. Maar hulle toe later aan het gesien, ja, maar die ouwense kos net opgeraak, ons gaan dan nou abie uitkom. Dan gee ek al klaar vir julle, spoiler. Hulle gaan nou met die derde toering ook begin. The fence is more than 1,150 roods in length and has been completed by 30 men in 20 days. The only serious drawback to the fence lies in the likelihood of it catching fire to prevent which three persons have been appointed as fire watchers. Today three carpenters have been commissioned in the forest, which is close at hand, to trim the timber for the third watch house, the framework of which they shall then erect with all haste and complete it with boards. This watch house shall be called Hout den Bul, so dis Hou die Bul. Nie keer die koei nie, dis Hou die Bul, of is dit hout soos in hout, 'n houtbul. Dit mag dalk 'n houtbul wees, want hy word van hout gebou. Een van die twee, al twee maak vir my sin. Kies vir julle watter een julle meer van nou. Ons praat 'n bietjie hier van Saldanha. Die Beguin kom terug. They reported that a ship has been seen at sea last Sunday to the west of the island. En dan hier kom nou 'n briefie van Robben Eiland nou en hierdie vuur wat gemaak is. En daar te geonderstreep, their provisions has run out, en dit is nou maar basis waar dit gegaan het, en praat hulle hier oor die hassies en so aan. Ek sal graag wil, hier skryf Jan van Riebeek nou 'n lang love letter terug, van Curly Cabbage, hier kom die Curly Cabbage nou. Die mense wat daar, en hulle wil, der duisende varke wil hulle graag op Robben Eiland aanhou. Die ouwens wil baloney maak. Die mense wil baloney maak en hulle wil nou daar duisende varke en alles gaan nou hierso, hierdie curly cabbage, hulle noem hierdie curly cabbage 'n paar keer in hierdie stuk, maar hulle moet nou eers hierdie curly cabbage groei voordat hulle nou die varke daar kan loslaat. Hier kom ons nou uiteindelik by nog 'n bietjie diplomatie. Ons trek nou al by die 20ste September, is nou al 'n maand gelede, en ons het nog niks gehoor van enige aanvalle of niks nie, so dinge is redelijk stil. The same weather with a south-southeasterly wind, which did not, however, blow very strongly. In the afternoon, the watch house, kyk uit, kan ek het nie maar uitkyk noem nie, signaled that Hottentots had been sighted, whereupon the horsemen on frontier duty and the free fishermen immediately made for the watch house, and some men from the fort at once followed suit. The mounted men got there first, and as the Hottentots showed a small flag, they discovered them to be followers of Udasua. They had come along with the interpreter Eva to bring us 7 or 8 sheep. So daar maak Eva nou ook weer 'n verskyning. After they had also been met by the party from the fort, they came in as friends. After Eva had conveyed to us her brother-in-law's greetings, and had mentioned various matters of minor importance, she said that Udasua had instructed her to inform us that the carpenters had visited him and asked him to lend them Eva's services so that she might sue for peace on their behalf. So hulle stuur nou vir Udasua se sister-in-law, skoonsister, om nou hierdie storie te kom gesels. Kom ons hoor wat hulle te sê het. But Udasua's reply to their request had been that they had Duman, who had been trained in the commander's household in the same way as Eva and could speak Dutch quite adequately. Nevertheless, Udasua had agreed to Eva's conveying the request, since in the encounter with the fiscal the overseer of the company's stables had wounded Dumont with a shot which had entered his body at the shoulder blade and passed out again through the chest. Nou, maar hy is nou natuurlijk van achter af geskiet as hy hierdie kant in is en die kant uit. Three others had also been seriously wounded and no one else among the Kaapmans dared approach us. Eva further had to say that the Kaapmans would return to us half the number of stolen cattle and sheep. Since the thieves had consumed the rest and all the stolen Dutch sheep. At this point, Eva asked whether Udusua had not told the Kaapmans that this was a most unsatisfactory offer, and that they should rather consider returning twice as many as they had robbed us of. Nou maar, hulle kom nou sê, ja, ons kan vir jou helfte van jou skape teruggee, die ander is weg, sorry man. Sê Jan vir hulle terug, ek soek ten minste twee keer soveel terug as wat hulle gesteel het. Hierdie besigheid is onaanvaarbaar. She replied that he had told them to offer us as many as they had seized, and that Udusua felt disposed to persuade them to do so if it should prove possible, and to entreat us to accept the offer. Since in response to their continued request, he had promised to act as mediator. We told her that we would make our decision known when she and her party were on the point of leaving. Nou, want daar is nou die diplomatie stukkie. We bartered 8 sheep from the above Saldanas, en dan nou hieronder sê hulle ook, for the loss of 8 of their finest and bravest men, and for having 3 men besides Dumont lying seriously injured and in danger of succumbing to their wounds. There was accordingly much desertion among them, not to mention the weeping and the lamentation of the women, because the Goracho-Hukwas had lost 2 of their bravest men in the above-mentioned encounter. Ek moet seker maar eerder hierdie stuk heeltemal deurlees. Ek het nog gedink as 'n vinnige stuk. Kom ek lees hom deur. Ek begin oor. Ek moes hom deur gelees het. We bought 8 sheep from the above Saldanas. Today we held further discourse with Eva, who said among other things that the Kaapmans tribe was most annoyed with Dumont. They reproached him daily and blamed him of their being deprived of the fine enjoyment of their friendly intercourse with the Dutch, for their having to live like outlaws for the loss of 8 of their finest and bravest men, and for their having 3 men besides Dumont lying seriously injured and in danger of succumbing to their wounds. There was accordingly much desertion among them, and not to mention the weeping and the lamentation of the women, because the Goracho-Hukwas, who had lost 2 of their bravest men in the above-mentioned encounter, so that our attention had now been turned to them too. They had separated from the Kaapmans after some of them had on this account committed acts of hostility against the Kaapmans, and so their deeds having brought shame and disgrace upon them, they had come humbly to Udusua, and that he might plead with us for peace on their behalf. For this reason, Udusua had sent Eva to us to represent the case and to request kindly that we should accept them in the mercy and friendship as before, because of their action against the Dutch, they at present found themselves completely beset with enemies on all sides and dare not remain peacefully in one place for a single day. Always imagining that they had heard the Dutch firing, and always in anxiety lest they should at any time be most grievously surprised by them. Eva was thereupon asked whether they had not doubtly deserved this, etc. She replied that she thought they had, and that her brother-in-law Udusua had moreover said as much to her. But if on this occasion the commander would forgive these poor wretches, en ek het nog gaan opsoek daar, hulle sê in die boek, dis die arme bloed, these poor wretches, these were her very words, Udusua would do his best to ensure that we received satisfaction and had all our stolen livestock returned to us. To this we replied that if they themselves brought back all the livestock, we would talk about peace because of Udasua's request and by no means for their own sakes. Okay. Ek wonder is dit lak tyd. Dis nou tyd vir 'n breek. Ek is jammer. Dis alweer tyd vir 'n breek. Ek begin 'n trek swaar hierso. Mense, is julle nog wakker? Dan moet ons nou maar hier in stilte sit. RJ en Jay gooi ook oogies. Julle gaan nou maar net moet wag dat ek my entjie klaar hoek. Om my ekstra vir julle te noem, ek kry nogal warm. Kom ek maak 'n bietjie. Sien julle is nou nog lig. O, ja. Kom ek draai die kamera so. Daar by die venster uit. En dis nou al klaar 8 uur. En ek weet nog by my vorige episode, ek het hom gaan kyk. By my vorige episode het ek nog gesê, dis nou 7 uur. En dis nou net mooi donker geword. En dis nou amper 'n uur later. En dis nog steeds redelik lig. Sien, dit was redelik warm vandag. Maar ek moes nou toekap. Anders is die lig te veel in die kamer, kan julle niks op die kamera sien nie. Maar die son het dan maar so klein bietjie. Kom my koel liggie nou deur. Kan ek weer dink. My ore het nou warm gekry. Is dit al pikdonker in Johannesburg? Ek kan te glo nie, Johannesburg is tegnies nie so ver nie, maar dis nog lig, ek kan nog dor in die horizon insien. Dis snaaks hoe die verskil so groot is. Moet julle sien? Aan Johannesburg gaan is seker lekker, want hier in die Kaap, as ons werk toe gaan, is alles nog piknag donker. En dit is alles omdat ons rondom julle tyd wil werk. Ons wil ook daylight savings time hê in die Kaap, ons eie landstig. Ons werk op Pretoria tyd. Ons moet op Cabo de Boa Esperance werk. Ja, julle is van die son gewys. Julle sien eers die son. Alright. So Eva het weer haar gesiggie gewys in. Sy sê, mens kan ook nie glo wat die mense altyd vir jou sê nie. Ons het mos nou al 'n paar keer in die boek gesien, ek meen, mense met alles wat jy lees, veral wat wat van die Kaapen se kant af kom. En ook uit Eva se mond uit. Jy moet dit maar vat met 'n knippie sout. Mens moet dit maar vat met 'n knippie sout. Die arme bloeds. Ok, hier is nou what the actual fuck. Hoor nou hierso. Hulle het nou net gekom pleit vir vrede. Dis nou die, daai was op die 21ste gewees, nou September 1659. 21ste, op die 22ste, hier skryf hulle. Still strong and dry south-southeasterly winds in the morning. Eva and her party left in the forenoon with the above reply, taking with them some presents for each of them. So, hulle het nou die antwoord gegee, en hulle stuur nou vir Eva, en hulle stuur presentjie saam en so aan. As well as some for Udasua and his wife. In spite of this, they called at the Rideau Deinhoop on their way past, and finding nobody there but the black wife of the freeburger Jan Zacharias, they seized a pair of tongs and an axe, and then assaulted her. She called out to Eva, who, she says, refused to come to her aid, but only slapped her hand on her thigh and continued on her way. Ek weet nie hoe dit werk nie. Dalk het die vrou Eva se ma gevloek of so iets, ek weet nie. Wat het daar gebeur? Hier word die vyand nou gewaar. Hulle nou kom vra vir vrede, kyk wat gebeur hierso. Towards evening, word was received that 13 Hottentots had been seen at the Bosheuvel this morning. Dit is natuurlik Jan van Riebeeck se wingerd wat daar staan. They had passed above the Pega Pega, or protective fence constructed along the slopes of the Bosbergen, had crossed the furthest part of Leonard Cornelissen Forest, and on returning, had again entered the forest. We are still ignorant of what their intentions were. Nou, jylle kan verder daar gaan lees, hulle net die ouwens gewaar, en hier is nou een klomp bespiegeling wat hier aangaan, maar dis alles net bespiegeling. Die mense wat daar wil gaan saamlees, na die tyd kan daar gaan lees. Ek maak die ookie gauw een bykie korter, dalk staan hy beter. Mense, die besigheid val rond vandaan. Hier kom een skip in die Kaap, en ons trek nou al by die 24ste September 1659. Oeh, dis die skip met die naam Erasmus, en hulle sê, she had lost 30 persons through illness, and was very short of food and provisions. Nou die Erasmus is in baie moeilikheid. Hier is een kopie van die dagboek. En julle kan sien hierdie besigheid 27 January. In the evening after much trouble, we managed to get through the Straits of Sunda into the open ocean with the aid of a topsail breeze. So hier begin hulle story. Nou ons trek maar by September. So dit is nou Februari, Maart, April, Mei, Juni, Juli, Augustus, September, 9 maande later. Nou maar jylle kan van die hele expeditie hier so, man, hou so groot soos vuiste, so groot soos tennisballe, praat hulle hiervan. Nou, dis nou nadat hulle al klaar in die moeilikheid was, hulle is nou al by Madagaskar rond, we found a small English yacht at anchor there. She had been fitted out and equipped by the new United British Society. En hulle verwys nou dit as this friendly ship. Ons weet ons in die Engelse, het is so lekker oor die weg gekom altyd. Het gaan daarmee vir ewig aan. En die trek is nou by die 19de Augustus, dis nou al amper waar as nou is. On their return from the first trip, our men reported that they had met with some human beings who however, were so timid that they could do nothing with them. En dis nou natuurlijk die plaaslike inboerlinge van Madagaskar. En dan natuurlijk hier op die 25ste September, waar ons omtrent nou trek. Praise be to God, at last 8 months and 10 days after leaving Batavia, we have safely arrived in the Bay of Good Hope. 30 mense is oorlede en daar's nog 'n hele klomp siek van hulle ook. En smaak my, hulle gaan 'n bietjie hier, kom hulle nou met 'n resolusie. Ons gaan nou hoe hulle nou gaan maak met hierdie mense, want die skip is nou duidelik in die moeilikheid. Ek sit net op vir die mense wat belangstel na die tyd, as hulle wil saamlees, hoe hulle nou gaan maak, hulle gaan nie goed, kos en goed nou weer moet herverdeel, en allerhande administrasiewerk wat gedoen moet word. Ok, daar was nou die belangrikste goed. Die mense is nog steeds hier so, en die skip is nog steeds in die moeilikheid. Moet nie een fout maak hier. Ons trek nou by die ultimo, die laaste dag van September 1659. The weather being fine, the commander was out early this morning to carry out his customary inspection of all activities, and also to mark off the site for the third of the watchhouses. Dis nou natuurlijk die houtebol. For which the timber has already been prepared. He did this and named the watchhouse Hout den Bul. En hulle praat ook hierso van hoe goed dit gaan met die Pega Pega. En hulle sê ook hieronder, hierdie mense van die Erasmus. Hulle steek sommer vir hulle ook aan die werk. As some of the men from the return yacht Erasmus sent into the forest to help drag out the logs needed for the fence, we found to be too weak. The commander allowed these men to return home. He decided that he would go aboard the ship tomorrow or the day after to see whether the rest of them were just as sickly or were in any way unwell, so that he might determine whether the seamen should continue to help us or should be excused. Nou, maar dis nou Jan van Riebeek se specialiteit. Hy is nou eindelijk 'n dokter. En jy kan julle sien of hulle het van die mense aan die werk gesteek toe wel. Nou, hier is nou waar Van Riebeek nou op die skip geklim het en hy sê, their complexion and physique were generally unhealthy, so that they themselves were given the choice of being employed in the forest. So hy sê vir julle, die mense wil kom werk, kan kom werk, daar julle sal vergoeding kry, julle sal betaling kry, soos enige een van die ander maatskappy manne, en hy smaak my, 'n paar van hulle het gesê, asseblief ja, en 'n paar van hulle het gesê nee. Op die volgende dag sê hulle, when the men working in the forest returned home in the afternoon, the 11 men from the yacht Erasmus, who have been helping them this week, were given the choice of going back on board, but of their own accord they asked that they might be allowed to continue transporting the timber, even if the work should go on all the time they were here. This is of great assistance to us here. Dit is natuurlijk een spanniekie van hulle wat nie so sleg gevoel het, en ek kan imagine as jy nou vir 8-9 maanden gestrand was, jy wil nie graag op nou nog op die skip die hele tyd wees nie, jy wil graag van die skip af wees. In elk geval, dit smaak want daar is 11 van hulle wat redelijk fiks is, en hulle help my mooi, en Jan is toch te bly vir hulle op. Die manne is baie nederig, hulle het nou net uit 'n moeilike tyd uitgekom. Dit smaak hoe snaaks die moeilike tye mense gewoonlik baie vinnig nederig maak. Nou mense kan hoor, hierdie ouens baie nederig op die oomblik. Hier kom 'n skip aan, dit is die Malakka. Die Malakka het al 'n paar keer hier in die Kaap gestop. With of 352 paid men, of whom 36 had died, and about another 30 were ailing. So dit gaan ook nie baie goed met die Malakka nie. Ons gaan nou nog meer van hom lees. Hier is nou net 'n love letterkie van Robben Island. Niks te interessant daar so nie. Hier praat hulle weer oor die Erasmus, ek gaan ook weer so halfie so oor dit spring, die mense wat daarin belang stel kan daar gaan saamlees. Ek gaan net so hier en daar een of twee highlights vir julle lees. The taking of a decision on the Erasmus' departure has been postponed until the next meeting of the council. So hulle moet nog besluit wat gaan hulle met hierdie mense maak. Dis maak my Jan hou van die 11 gesonde manne wat hier is, van sy eie manne. Ons het ons in die begin van die episode gelees. Hulle is weer barstig en die ouens wil nie werk en die slawe is ook weer barstig, hulle wil nie werk. Maar hierdie nederige manne, hulle wil werk. Hier praat ons nog oor die Erasmus. It has thus been decided that these shall be furnished by the Malakka. So hulle gaan goedere van die Malakka afhaal en dan vir die Erasmus gee. Daar is die hele lys van goed. Hulle sê ook, it is considered that with these supplies the yacht will be adequately provided to complete her voyage to the fatherland. Ook is waar hulle voel dat die goed wat nou gegee is nou genoeg. Maar daar is een ander drol in die drinkwater. Kom ek lees van die begin van die sin af. Waar begin die sin? Hierso. There were further deliberation, however, and it was pointed out that the honours in the fatherland had expressly decreed that the ships of the honourable company should for no reason whatever, except if there were very grave danger of life or property, attempt to put in at foreign harbours, and that the return ships were therefore strictly forbidden to sail through the channel between England and France. Natuurlijk die Straits of Dover, die smal kanaalkie. But should follow the courteous course. Dis nou natuurlijk die een wat rondom die Verenigde Koninkryk gaan, die een by Ierland en Skotland daar agterom. So daar is nou iets wat hulle gecounter het. Hulle sê ook, furthermore, the council bore in mind that Swedish and English raiders under the Swedish flag abounded not only at the heads and everywhere in the North Sea. Nou, the heads is natuurlijk daar by Dover, daar klein strijd, but also on the courteous route, and that they regularly attacked and robbed ships flying our flag. Because of these and other additional difficulties, the council decided by a majority vote that the return yacht Erasmus should not be granted permission to sail before the arrival of the return fleet, which is expected about the middle or end of February, and that she should wait here until then. Nou, dis maak my die skipper van die Erasmus stel was nou nie baie bly gewees oor hierdie besluit nie, maar ek meen die Lanies is nou allemaal lief en hulle het nou gebesluit, dit sal nou wees, die Erasmus moet bly, Jan van Riebeek is ook baie dankbaar vir die extra hulp. 11 ywerige manne, wat die Pega kom opstel. It was decided by a majority vote that the honorable company's interest would be served if the Erasmus waited until the return fleet arrived. Heritereel hulle net so. Wat is die ander ou? Frederik Verburg, Gatgrijpe Verburg. Hulle praat van die, dit was hy wat daar in die tulp ongeluk gemaakt het rondom Madagaskar en die ouwens geloof oorlede daar so. Hier is een van die ouwens wat so half nou gehop, huis toe het, en hier so is hy nou Jelle Hendricks of Kruinger. Moes hierdie ou nie avontuur gebeleef het, he. Jammer, hy het hier een dagboek gehad, he. Oorlog en diplomatie. Ons al klaar hier in die gang. Ek lees hopeloos te starig. Mens is nog een lang stuk. Hier is nog baie om te lees. Ok. Een entjie. Een lang stuk se lees. En dan is dit verby. Het julle niks om vir my te sê nie. Ek kom dan nou juist onder aan die live met mense te gesels en hier is nou niemand wat my wil gesels sê. Julle maak my hart so seer. In elk geval, dit is baie stil, ons het nou al amper 2 maande gelees en daar was nog geen aanvalle gewees en daar was een klein groepie gewaar gewees. Even hulle het gekom en gepleit vir, jy weet, een bykie vrede. Nog in Oktober is daar nog informatie van diplomatie en daar het type goed eindelijk die rede hoekom ons die boek lees. Ek wil net hier oor die ander goed oorslaan, want alles is so half gelinkt met mekaar. Ons luister vir die onderwijser. Jong, dit moet nou eindelijk so wees, dat ek gedog hierdie is so half vir ons lees saam story. Want ek lees net 2-3 maande vooruit, na gaan ek live. Ek het nie hierdie boek klaar gelees, he. Ek weet nie wat gaan gebeur in die toekomst, he. Net soos julle. Ek weet wat die rest van die maand gaan gebeur, ja, maar dis waar het eindig. Julle kry hem rou uit die koeise speen uit. Is nou nog even lig. Die ding is RJJ, ek kan nou opsomming episode doen, maar mens kan nie hierdie 3 volumes in 1 episode opsom nie. Ek het ander dag het ek weer gesê, nie weet, so 'n ou goed kyk van my, daar was 'n tyd, ek het lekker edits gemaakt, kwaai edits. Dan praat ek so lekker sag hier teen die nie tegen die microfoon, dat allemaal my mooi duidelik kan hoor, dit voel eindelijk half of julle in my mond sit. Daar die type episodes. Lekker waar die goeie so invuid en weer uitvuid, jy weet, en maybe maak die klipkop maniekie so, elke nou en dan, jy weet. Zit misschien zo'n beatbox beat in de achtergrond. Lekker episodiekjes gemaakt. Je weet, zo'n opzomming. Als die boek klaar is, dan vat ik zo'n maand. Dan probeer ik net dit doen. Maar ek het nog gekyk, laatste keer sy episode, al te saam, ek denk 74 views nou. So dit begin, ek het so half gesê, ja maar as hy nou minder as 100 views kry, dan is dit redig waar die moeite werd om nog aan te gaan met die boek. Ek gaan nou maar aan, omdat ek nie vir julle wil teleurstel nie, om eerlik met julle te wees. Johan sê, dit is so lang gelede dat jy online was. Ek het skielik my Afrikaans vergeet. Dit smaak my, ek het ook half my Afrikaans vergeet. Ek struikel oor my woorde. Ja, maar Arthur J, jy praat van 'n opsomming episode. Hier is ten minste nog 'n paar maande se episodes voordat hierdie boek klaar is. Die groot in detail informatie kom nog. Maar ja, ek geloof dat almal het al klaar beter begrip van wat die realiteite aan die Kaap was. Oor wie is die volgende boek? Ek het daaraan ook gedink. Ek het gewonder of julle nie kan kom met voorstel. Wat wil julle graag hê? Ek het een agent X het vir my 'n voorstel gegee waarvan ek nogal baie hou. En dit gaan oor die term Afrikaner. Wie was die eerste Afrikaner? Nou maar daar so is, ek weet nie of die ou se naam Jan Afrikaner was nie. Want die ou was nie 'n blanke gewees nie. Hy was, jy weet, spicy. Hy was kalet. Griek kwam meer, maar ek weet ook nie heeltemal nie. Dit is, die theorie achter die boek is, dat jy weet, die Afrikaner identiteit het oorspronkelijk eintlik baie min te doen gehad met Europeërs. Die oorspronkelijke, die ware Afrikaner praat ek nou van. Daar waar die Afrikaner idee as 'n groep, tussen daar as 'n groep mense wat nie spesifiek van hierdie area is, wat hier kom bly, en hierdie area geaanvaar het as hulle area, hier gekolonaliseer het. Daai. En ek dink, dit sal nogal interessant wees, en dit sal natuurlijk 'n paar mense trigger. Hendrik Bibou. Nee man, Hendrik Bibou is die ou wat gesê het, ek ben een Afrikaner. Maar mens kan hom so ook terugtrek. Hy het toch, wel. Ek probeer nou vir myself justify dat, hoe dit eintlik nog nie heeltemal die Afrikaner identiteit beteken het, maar dit beteken toch wel. Al het hy gebedoel van, ja, ek val nie onder Hollandse wette nie. Is dit maar nog steeds dieselfde, ek val nie onder Hollandse wette nie, ek is my eie volk hierso. Ek dink dat Bibou was hier gebore, sover as ek weet. Daar is van die historiekuste, wat beweer, hy was verward gewees oor sy identiteit. Ek dink nie die leitie was verward gewees oor sy identiteit. Ek dink hy was juist baie oortuig. Hy het nie nodig gehad om te top daar oor nie. Hy het geweet wie hy is. Hoe onthou julle die goed? Van Hendrik Bibou. Ek weet jy, lees er net baie. As jy het nou 7-8 keer klaar, 7-8 keer raak gelees het, dan onthou jy hom seker maar. Ok, waar was ons by? Hierso. Ok, hier kom nou weer een lang leesstuk. Ons is nou al 10 minute, 1 uur en 10 minute in die story in. Ons trek by die 13de en die 14de Oktober 1659. In the afternoon, the wind began to blow very strongly from the same direction. The Freiburger Pieter Janssen of Middelburg came to tell us that he had met 9 Hottentots near the Boshevel. They had surrounded him and after some preliminary remarks had repeatedly requested him to fetch them a flag from the fort so that they might approach the commander in safety and confer with him. Janssen was given a flag for them and went back accompanied by a soldier as well as the 3 mounted men on the frontier duty who were to remain out of sight but near him. And so before evening he returned to the fort bringing the Hottentots with him. They had belonged to Harry's people known as the Watermen, whom we last heard of when the corporal Elias Geers fired on them behind the Cape Mountains on the 3rd of August. Ek onthou nog daai stukkie. They tried to excuse themselves by saying that they were not to blame for the hostilities which had begun or for the stealing of cattle, which had all been started by the Kaapmans under Dumont's leadership and at his instigation. They begged that our men should no longer be sent out to hunt them down, but that they might be permitted, as of old, to erect their huts and settle with their wives and children in the vicinity of the fort. This would enable them to serve us by fetching firewood and water and by catching fish, since they possessed no cattle, nor indeed any of them any form of wealth other than what they obtained from the sea by means of fishing, which was always of great benefit to the common people. When we asked them if they knew where the Kaapmans were in hiding, they answered that they did not know, for they and the Kaapmans were not sufficiently friendly to have much to do with each other. Ek voel half die was a bullshit story. Maar, dis net my opinie. Though they had recently heard that the Kaapmans had taken refuge with Udesua, in return for which he had received from them several head of cattle of those they had stolen from us. The Watermen therefore believed that Udesua and the Kaapmans had moved far inland. Nou, maar die story wat ons nou van Eva se kant afkry oor Udesua en die story wat ons nou van die strandloper afkry van Udesua is 2 heel verskillende stories. Dit teken 'n heel verskillende prentjie. So wie moet jy nou eintlik glo? Jy moet jou geskiedenis ken, maar die geskiedenis leer vir ons dat jy nie die geskiedenis kan vertrou nie. Ek verstaan dit nie. Ek verstaan dit, verduidelik dit vir my. On being asked whether they would go and find out for us where these tribesmen were, the Waterman replied that it would be impossible to do this immediately. But if we granted their request to come and settle here near the fort for the reasons already mentioned, some of the Kaapmans would in time be sure to come and visit them by night or at some unseasonable hour in order to get another chance of opening peace negotiations. We had placed Harry behind a thin partition where he could hear everything these people said so that we might be able to find out whether they were deceiving us. But when we questioned him afterwards, he declared that they were certainly his people and they had spoken the truth. Whereupon the members of the council were asked to think about the matter so that it might be decided tomorrow that what we should do about these 9 Hottentots, whether we should let them go or make them our prisoners. We faced in that the same fears south-southeasterly wind the commander and the council of the fort of Good Hope took the following resolution. Ach, ek gaan net so die onderstreep te lees. And after some discussion agreed that it would be unjust and unreasonable to detain or arrest any persons who came to sue for peace of their own free will. Okay, so hulle smaak, maar hulle gaan die mense so af toelaat om om weer hier te kom bly. Hier sê ek tog, ek het juist 'n nota gemaak, lees als. Kom ek lees als. Nie oorskiepie. Okay, kom ek begin van die begin af. The south-southeasterly wind continued to blow so strongly that no boats could ply and from the ships lying in the roadstead, and the officers of these ships could therefore not be summoned ashore to augment the council in its deliberations over the Hottentots then at the fort. As the decision on this matter could not for various reasons be delayed any longer, but had in fact to be reached as soon as possible, the ordinary council at the fort took the matter in hand and after some discussion agreed that it would be unjust and unreasonable to detain or arrest any persons who came to sue for peace of their own free will, even though they were enemies and had been active in stealing cattle, a charge which, however, they attempted to deny. Moreover, these beggarly fellows possessed nothing at all, and their detention would cause such resentment and distrust among the others with whom the Honorable Company is chiefly and directly concerned, that they would never dare to come near here. On the other hand, if we complied with the Waterman's present request by allowing them free access as of old, and connived at their misdeeds of the past, the other tribesmen might be encouraged to venture more openly into this neighborhood, and thus in due time give us better opportunity either of wreaking suitable vengeance upon them, or of entering into and maintaining such agreements with them as time and circumstances might lead us to decide were in best interest of the Honorable Company and the common weal. It is also borne in mind that the protective fence intended to prevent the Hottentots from driving the cattle away across the river had not yet been completed and was not ready for use, so that we had no option but to keep a full force in the field to guard our cattle. Another consideration is that our livestock had been sorely depleted because we were supplying the ships staying here, so that we were forced always to bear in mind by what means we might obtain more livestock, barter being the preferable method. But if we made prisoners of these watermen, barter would be out of the question, and the Karpmans, our principal enemies, could by no means be enticed sufficiently near the fort for us to inflict enough revenge on them by making use of opportunities such as we have often had in the past. It was hoped that by our allowing these Hottentots their liberty, we should eventually get such an opportunity, or at least that matters should go so far that they would effect a reconciliation and hand over some of the stolen livestock. It might also make bartering with other Hottentots an easier process, since at present under Udasua's influence, they are trying to cut off all trade with us, because Udasua is making them all dislike us. As some countermeasure to this is necessary, and we cannot prevent these or any other Hottentots from spying out our positions, it was decided that no better course could be followed for the time being than to grant these watermen free and unrestricted passage to and from the fort. It is hoped that when they see the steady improvement of our defences, the Hottentots would be less willing to disrupt them, though a very close watch and sharp lookout would be kept everywhere and everybody would be warned to be on the alert. Work on the protective fence and on strengthening of other defensive works will also be energetically pursued. Thus done and resolved in the fort of Good Hope on the above date, and daar is al die laanies wat geteken het. When this resolution had been taken, the above mentioned Hottentots, with whom we are provisionally reconciled, were set at liberty and were conducted beyond all the Freeburgers' houses by the fiscal, who showed them what places to avoid every time they came in future and along what routes they could travel to and fro. Dan op die 16e, owing to the careless stoking of an oven, the house of the Freeburger Hendrik Boom was burned to the ground this evening. Ek weet in 'n vorige hoofstuk het ons gelees van Hendrik Boom was besig, hy letterlik vir my aftreehuisie gebou. 'N Baie weelderige huis, en as maak my hierdie huis het nou afgebrand. Maar hulle sê nie veel meer daarvan nie. diplomatie van Saldanha Bay af. In a northwesterly breeze, the vessels of the Freeburgers arrived from the Dassen Island and the Saldanha Bay with some fish and eggs. They brought news that they had met Udasua's people and some of the tobacco thieves there and had obtained more than 20 of their sheep in barter. Hulle sê ook, since they had found the attitude of the Hottentots to be nothing but cordial. So hulle het nou, daar is nou so half weer een paar skaapjes gekoop, daar is net 30 skaap op Robben Island, en julle gaan nou sien, hulle gaan nou plan maak om, jy weet, weer die aankopery, die bater te begin. Hier kom die resolusie nou. Vir Pieter Potter. Since we have learned from the Free Saldanha traders that the Kochokwas are at present in the bay and feel disposed to trade, we have thought fit to send the Skapenjacht to you with 32.5 pounds of copper wire, 4 pounds of tobacco, enzovoorts, enzovoorts. Hulle moet nou skaap koop. En dan is er by, but before you depart from the bay, the four of you shall travel overland as you have been instructed and find out whether the Bay of Saldanha is at all close to the Saldanha Bay, whereupon you shall survey the bay and enter particulars. So hulle moet hierdie kaart basis net uitbrei. Kyk waar pas, hulle weet Sint Helena en Saldanha is redelijk nabij in mekaar, hulle wil net weet hoe nabij en al die type goed. Hier lees nou weer oor die watermen. As the watermen have come to live near the fort again, as recorded in the entry for the 15th, Harry has been secretly sent back to the Robben Island aboard the Skapenjacht without his people having seen him. He might never have existed for all the inquiries they make about him. Dan, hier is nou 'n moord. It would seem from the confession of the sergeant Allard of Haft and from additional investigations that there is no doubt that he stabbed Gillis of Muiden in the chest with his rapier this morning so that he died immediately of the wounds. The said sergeant declares in his confession that he did this in self-defense to prevent injury to life and limb. En daar sê hulle ook, has unanimously resolved to refer the case to their honours, the Governor-General and Councillors of India at Batavia for further deliberation. Hier is nou nie genoeg, hier is die mense met genoeg regkennis hier so nie. It is therefore decided that the sergeant shall be conveyed to Batavia as a prisoner in the Malacca. En dan kan ons sien die volgende dag, the Malacca got underway and by sailing to the east of the Robben Island soon reached the open seas. Well, the sergeant is now saam met die Malacca na die honorable masters toe. En hier begin het praat is nou oor die watermeel. Ek wonder of ek het hier moet afsluit. Dit is nou 24 oor. Ek gaan het hier afsluit. Ek is jammer mense. Want hier is nog redelijk baie leeswerk oor. En ek gaan het los vir volgende episode. 47 is die volgende episode. Episode 47. O, jalla, is nou net 5 mense oor. Nee, wat die besigheid is dood. Maar ek gaan mos dan nog maar aan. Die mense sê ek moet aangaan. Ek gaan nog maar aan. Steek haar eentje op. Eish ja. Nou maar as dit nou dit is, gaan ek het nou maar daar los. Laat dat dan zo wees. Ek hoop my shortcuts werk nog. Ek dink is alt 1 gewees. Ja! Mense, ek wil vir julle sê baie baie dankie toe ingeskakel. Onthou, daar is geen skaamte om jou kop uit jou gat te trek nie. Staan op vir daardie mense wat vir jou opstaan, soos altyd volhard in. Hou koers.